kgs of milk, it will feed 6,000 people. So in full lifetime, it will feed 90,000 people at one time. And the cow, if you kill, only 1,000 people. Which is better, 90,000 or 1,000? Why are you killing the goose that laying the golden egg daily? It's not a wise proposition, and I agree with that. But the point to be noted is that no milkman will ever give a milking cow to the slaughterhouse. No slaughterhouse will ever purchase a milking cow, because a milking cow is multiple times more expensive than a cow which has passed its age of milking. In Bombay, it costs 20 to 25,000 rupees milking cow. An old cow which has crossed the milking age costs only 3 to 5,000 rupees. So, what we do, we non-vegetarians, the cattle, we look after it till the time it gives milk. After it starts giving milk, we slaughter it. We take all the eggs of the goose. When it stops laying, we slaughter the goose for its flesh. Saap bhi mare aur lathi bhi na toote. Two birds with one stone. We are more intelligent. Again, the argument giving. That see, some animals, you can use them in field, etc. You can use them for plowing, for transportation. If you love the animals so much, why do you overload them? And furthermore, the Indian statistics tells us that out of the population of cows, oxes and bull, only 25% are productive. The remaining 75% are unproductive. Either past the age of milking or they are males, all and females, bulls, oxes. Now what will you do with the 75% of excess non-productive cow, goat, bulls, ox? One option, you rear them up yourself. An average bull or cow requires 18,000 a year for living, according to the statistics. Their statistics, not my statistics. 18,000 a year. So after they give milk, they live another 4-5 years. Which farmer will bear the burden of millions of cow every year 18,000? Second option is give to give their organization. They leave it open, it enters the field, eats up the crop. Third option, leave them in the jungle, animal will kill them. The last option is best, after they reach the age of milking, utilize the milk, give it to slaughterhouses, it benefits the farmer, he gets some money, and even the animal benefits the human being by eating the meat of the animal, as well as his hide for leather, as well as the bones. Hope that answers the question.
Next question for Mr. Zaveri.
According to Kastur Chand Jain, in the marriage of the 22nd Tirthankar, Aris Nemi, popularly known as Neminath, meat of animals and birds was served. And both the bride and the bridegroom, according to Shastra, were Jains. Another incident was quoted that Chenna, a Jain Shravika who was the wife of Bhimsar Shrenik, a contemporary of Mahavir, was pregnant. And she had the desire to eat the heart of her husband. Bhimsar's eldest son, Abhay Kumar, instead gave her some meat of a dead animal, and Chela, thinking it to be her husband's heart, ate it. I don't know how authentic is this article and whether what Kastur Chand said is true or false. What is its explanation? Please explain. I am referring to the article from the Caravan series, December 1981.
Thank you, sister. First of all, I will request the coordinator to only allow those questions coming out of my talk, not out of any other book or another references for which I am not responsible. But because I am a true Jain, I know definitely about the Jain history, about Neminath Tirthankar. Yes, it is true. That is why he propagated that the killing of, that is exactly why he renounced the world, that for my marriage, are you going to sacrifice all these innocent creatures? No, I don't want such a feast for me. And that is why he became a Jain Muni and ultimately a Tirthankar. So that is why I can say that all Jain Tirthankaras have absolutely, in absolute terms, have prohibited non-veg food. Thank you. And please restrict your questions to my talk only, not because it seems, I don't know, it seems that these books were given in all good faith, that they should understand our viewpoint. It seems that they are all distributed to those people and they are now asked to ask questions. I don't think that is fair. You can ask me any question from my talk. I will be very... happy to say, sir, that, I would like and to I will request
any question can be asked on the topic. When the thing is there, whether it's in the talk or out of the
talk, I don't mind.
Of the
that
speakers,
is okay.
Not necessarily. The
and another point I will tell any Mr. Coordinator that Mr. Y.P. Trivedi and myself, we both have got other meetings, so we would like to conclude within 5 minutes.
What I would suggest, see, the time given to both the speakers to speak was 50-50 minutes, then 15-15 minutes was for response, then we would have a question-answer session for 50 minutes. If any of the speakers would like to forfeit the time of not carrying on with the question session, and if they have an emergency, I would excuse them, but I would continue the question answer session for 50 minutes, because that has what been the chart given to me. I have to execute it like I had been told. Dr. Zakir cannot in his talk or response speak on any other religion. Forcefully got him not to speak on it. I'm telling you, forcefully I had to convince him you cannot touch anything else. I got him convinced because that was the request, his respect. Now what both speakers have agreed to, I have followed that. Anything which both speakers don't agree, I've thrown it out. Let me be very clear. We have said 50 minutes, we'll allow 50 minutes, but if one speaker would like to leave early for any emergency or any requirement, a person has got a full free will and a choice, I would respect that requirement, but we'll continue question answer for 50 minutes. I've written down the time, 12:45, close down at around 1:30. Right? So I think that is being very fair and clear on my part. The next question for Dr. Zakir.
Assalamu alaikum Zakir bhai. My name is Khan Abdustami and my question to you is, food value charts are distributed by vegetarians showing that the proteins and iron content of vegetarian food is higher than non-veg food. And thus they say veg food is more nutritious than non-food. Your comments please. Thank you.
So he asked a very good question. I would like to reply to the question posed by the learned speaker also. He doesn't know who distributed them. It is given in writing out here. It is given by Rishabh Foundation to IRF saying, we would be pleased to give you more such material in huge quantities if you like the same to be circulated among Muslim brothers in Mumbai. Free of charge, huh? The brother has asked a question that there are fruit charts being distributed. Yes, even we get in a foundation. We didn't respond, saying that it's not worth responding. It's not worth responding. But when the request came from the Rishabh Foundation, are you willing? I reluctantly agreed, you know, it is not a topic of scientific thing. It's a well-known fact. He said, yes, we'll debate. I said, fine, so I'm here, just replying. Why should people get irritated? If you can quote me from any book, as long as it's within the topic, I will inshallah answer. If I don't know, I will say I don't know. If I know, I will say no. I know your question, and when I got that chart, it gives food value chart, saying that proteins among the veg food is more than non-veg food. And even Mr. Rashmi Azhavedi in his talk, he said that the value of proteins, the quantity is more. Mr. Rashmi Azhavedi said that there were only 3 essential amino acids. You ask any doctor, it is not 3, it is 8. No wonder 5 is lacking. It is 8 essential amino acids which are not synthesized in the body. The remaining are synthesized. These essential amino acids should be given by the external food source. The proteins of animal foods, the biologically complete, known as higher protein, because they contain all the 8 essential amino acids. The veg protein are lacking in one or more of the essential amino acids. It's a scientific answer. So even though the value may be more, 20 up, 10 down, it is not complete. The veg protein, the incomplete protein of lesser quality, animal protein is of higher quality and complete protein. Similarly, if you analyze, even the iron you get from the diet is of 2 types. One is heme iron, one is non-heme iron. Heme iron can be absorbed easily in the body. Non-heme iron cannot be absorbed easily. In the animal food, there is heme iron as well as non-heme iron. The vegetable food contains very little heme iron. Therefore, they cannot absorb. Therefore, there's more deficiency of iron in them. So even I agree with you, the iron content in figures may be high. The protein content may be higher. Down the conclusion is, veg food is more nutritive. It's misleading the people. It's nothing but misleading. I would call it in plain English, fraud. Who's doing it? Some vegetarian society.
misleading the people. And fraud is prohibited in every religion, small or big. Whether major or minor religion, fraud is prohibited. So, I would like to ask a question. Would you prefer taking 10 notes of rupees 20 or 1 note or rupees 500? If you know the value for money, you choose the second. Hope that answers the question.
The next question for Mr. Zaveri.
Assalamualaikum. I am Javed Sheikh. My question is to Rashmi Bhai. Rashmi Bhai, in your talk, you mentioned that diseases transmitted through meat, flesh to human beings. But plants also affected by some diseases, viral, bacterial diseases. So you can get diseases from plant, vegetarian food also. You also mentioned Dean Ornish and Deepak Chopra, references and recommendation of those doctors. If you believe in recommendations of doctors and medical professionals, Trivedisa also mentioned that. If you believe in that, I will quote only simple example. When I was child, doctors, when I was suffering from fever, doctors were suggesting that don't take bath by cold water. But nowadays, they're telling, when I get fever, they're telling that please take bath by cold water only. See, so if you are believing in quotations, statistical data, and medical things, so please give statistical data. Dr. Zakir Naik mentioned survey of America regarding coronary heart disease. So do you have any statistical data regarding coronary heart disease in India, whether is affected to more susceptible to those who are having diet, vegetarian diet, or to non-vegetarian diet?
I would request you all to put your question briefly, please.
Your question is so long that one forgets.
Last part is question.
Coronary heart disease is last.
See, regarding coronary heart disease, plants also, if you consume the decayed the decayed fruits, definitely it will carry germs. The point here is that the animals that carry the germs, they are more dangerous and they are likely to carry more diseases than plant. Another thing is that which I have said is that animal food contains excessive protein, cholesterol and saturated fat. So these two things combined that will make non-veg food prohibitive. Coming to the statistics, I have got that book. There is no time, there is not a platform to argue about the statistics. I have got complete statistics that more people are suffering because of heart disease, those who are flesh eaters, than the veg people. Now, at the moment, I cannot give you those facts and figures that I have got it, then I can supply it to you later. Thank you.
No counter question, please. Yes, the next question for Dr. Zakir.
Assalamu alaikum, brother. Brother, my name is Safia. I'm a revert to Islam. My question is, in the book Vegetarian or Non-Vegetarian, Choose for Yourself by Gopinath Agarwal, there are quotations given from major world religions, including Hinduism and Christianity, that non-vegetarian is forbidden, prohibited. And how do you say it's permitted?
My sister asking the question, that there are quotations from the same book quoting various major world religions like Christianity and Hinduism, saying that in that religion it is prohibited. So how come I said that there is not a single major religion which says that non-veg food in general is prohibited? I clarified the Islamic viewpoint. It's a misquotation, out of context, misunderstanding. I do agree one thing, that there are certain quotations, sometimes non-veg food is prohibited even in Islam. Like, for example, the verse I quoted, Surah Maida, chapter 5, verse number 1, it says that don't do hunting in pilgrimage. Within the sacred pilgrimage, don't do hunting. If you are fasting in the month of Ramzan, sunrise to sunset, don't have non-veg food, don't even have veg food. If I say don't have non-veg food during fasting, that doesn't mean non-veg food is prohibited. Prohibited only during that time. So similarly, there are quotations in religious scriptures, at certain time in fasting, don't have non-veg food.
regarding the question in Christianity, and I've read that book, therefore I can reply. They say that in the Bible it is mentioned that you can't have dead food. In brackets they put meat. It's not there. What they're quoting, the reference is not given. I, being a student of comparative religion, I give talks on diets also. And they're referring to the book of Leviticus, chapter number 17, verse number 15, as well as the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 14, verse number 21. It says that thou shalt not have the meat that dieth of itself. Dead meat is prohibited. Not all meat. Dead meat. They say dead food and bracket meat. It is dead meat is prohibited. Even in the Quran. Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse 173, Surah Maidah chapter 5 verse number 3, Surah Al-Anam chapter 6 verse 145, Surah Nahl chapter 16 verse 115, Hurrimat alaykumul maytatu wad-damu walahmul khinzir, wama uhilla li ghayrillah bih. Forbidden for you for food, dead meat, blood, the flesh of swine, and any food on which any name besides Allah has been invoked. Where it is allowed? If you read the book of Genesis, chapter number 9, verse number 2 and 3, it says that they will fear you. They will dread you, all creatures of the earth, all fowls in the sky, all creatures that live on the earth, as well as all the fish in the sea, they shall be delivered to you. Next verse, Genesis chapter 9 verse 3 says that every creature that moveth on land and is a living creature, they are meat unto you, and also herbs and shrubs. Mention the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 14 verse number 9, that ye shall have the meat of all the things in the water, all that has fins and scales you shall eat. Deuteronomy chapter number 14 verse number 11 says that you shall have the lawful meat of the birds. Deuteronomy chapter number 14 verse number 20 says that you shall eat the meat of the lawful fowls. It's allowed. Further, if you read, it's mentioned in the book of Hebrews chapter number 5 verse number 13 and 14, that if you have milk, you are weak. If you have strong meat, you are powerful in reasoning. Bible says that, not I. In the Gospel of Luke, chapter number 24, only quotation, verse number 41 to 43, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, goes in the upper room, and he says, have you any meat to eat? And the disciples gave him a piece of broiled fish and honeycomb, fish, and he ate before them. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. In the book of Romans, chapter number 14, verse number 2 and 3, it says that one who believeth in eating all things, he can eat. Those who are weak, they only eat herbs and shrubs. But anyone who eateth should not insult those who eateth not. And those who eateth not should not judge those who eateth. This is law of God. Hindu scriptures. If you read the law of Manu, chapter number 5, verse number 30, it's clearly mentioned that the eater can eat any creature that lives, even if he eats every day. Our creator created some creatures to eat and some to be eaten. Laws of Manu, Manusmriti, chapter number 5, verse number 31, it says that if you eat in a sacrifice, this is the law of a god. Manusmriti, chapter number 5, verse number 42, it says that a twice born
yes. brother no, please.
I'm always prepared when I quote scriptures. Therefore, it's not on the table, it's inside. I wasn't supposed to quote unless compelled otherwise. Now they're compelling me to answer. Therefore, I kept it behind. Otherwise, my books are in the front always. They're compelling me to reply, therefore I'm replying. It's within the rules of the debate. I haven't completed it. So I have to speak for 5 minutes. What?
We would request anyone not to disturb in between.
Yes, please don't disturb.
The question.
And again, who's disturbing? See,
we'll allow another 20 seconds, you know, because this wastes time, you know. And then my time is up, I will stop the speaker.
No, but someone disturbs me, I should get more time.
Okay, we give. Complete the answer in 30 seconds.
It's further mentioned in the Manusmriti chapter number 5,
verse number 35, you can have meat. In Rig Veda, book number 10, hymn number 16, verse number 10, you can have meat. Rig Veda, book number 10, hymn number 85, verse number 13. Rig Veda, book number 10, hymn number 86, verse number 13. Says the same thing. You can have meat in Mahabharata, Anushasan Parv, chapter 88. If you read, Bhishma gives the advice to Yudhishthir. It's also mentioned in Manusmriti, chapter number 3, verse number 256 to 272. It's mentioned there that if you want to please your ancestors, if you give herbs and shrubs, you will gratify them only for 1 month. If you give fish, for 2 months. If you give venison, the flesh of deer, for 3 months. If you give mutton, for 4 months. If you give flesh of birds, for 5 months. If you give goat meat, for 6 months. If you give spotted deer, for 7 months. If you give meat of black antelope, for 8 months. If you give cow, 1 full year. If you give bull, it is 12 years. And if you give rhinoceros and red meat of goat, forever, inexhaustible. So if you have to satisfy your ancestors, according to Rig Veda, you have to give more, you have to give red meat.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Gulfam, and this question goes to Mr. Zaveri. Sir, in your dialogue, you said, Jain Munis don't kill plants, they ask for alms. So is it that they force others to kill plants for them? Or is it that when they put masks on their face, they are not killing the germs and others are killing the germs by not putting the mask on the face? What is it? Please clarify.
It's a very good question, sister. I am really very happy. Of all the questions, I would definitely give you first number, because it is said in Jain religion that you should not kill anybody, you should not allow anybody to kill, and you should not appreciate if one kills. So all these three things are there. So if a Jain Muni comes to know that this food is prepared for him, he will not take it. So this is the rule of Jain Muni. When they come to us for begging, they ask us very clearly, we also know that they will ask us, have you prepared anything for us? We have to very honestly say, we have not prepared anything, it is for us. We have prepared, say, 4 chapatis, he will take only 1, we will be happy with 3. This is the way of begging of a Jain Muni. He will not kill, he will not allow others to kill, he will not propagate killing, he will not even eat. If he comes to know that this food is prepared for a Jain Muni, I am happy that in this august and enlightened audience, I have been given an opportunity to clear the viewpoints of Jain Muni. Thank you very much, and I will now request the coordinator next. That Mr. Trivedi and myself, it is really going on so nicely that we would like to continue here for hours together, but I am sorry that time
so
constraint
is
such.
Last 2 questions, we'll allow 5 minutes are left.
I don't think it will be...
I think we have been talking so much about vegetarian food and non-vegetarian food, but we are all hungry now. I think we should go and eat. So only last 2 questions and then we disperse.
Mr. Trivedi has said we'll allow last 2 questions on the mic. When can we have the next question for Dr. Zakir? Yes. Acha, there's a request for Mr. For you want to ask question too? No, but they should have to follow. But I think you should have come up in the queue, you know.
Assalamu alaikum. My question for Zakir bhai is, are non-vegetarian food deficient in
There is a request from the other speaker. What we will do, what I will do, see, but there is a request from the side, allow 1 or 2 people to ask questions to Dr. Zakir. What I would suggest, let the speakers, in the time they are available here, let the other 2 speakers ask question. Then Mr. Trivedi and Mr. Zaveri can leave. Then I will give the chance so that I am not unfair to you also, both people. So that, no, I have told them they wanted to leave, so I have to give them an opportunity to leave. They wanted those 2 people to ask question, they can ask Dr. Zakir. Which are the 2 people, Mr. Zaveri? Mr. Bade and aap dono ko chance de denge ek. Then after that, we will carry on. The other 2 people will be given chance so that I'm not unfair to them. I hope the audience bears with me. for another 10. Mr. Trivedi and Mr. Zaveri would like to leave after that. So let those two people ask question. Acha, we'll allow only... No.
He is leaving. Let us ask two questions to him and let him hear.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, let us also ask a question.
Okay. Yes, agreed. Let those two people ask question which Mr. Zaveri has requested. Mr. Bade, who's Mr. Bade? Acha, one Mr. Bade and that...
Rule, okay.
Will not... Acha, and the other two, they two... Acha, we'll allow them to ask two questions to...
To Dr. Hussain.
Excuse me, Mr. Zaveri. Okay. Now one question for one question he'll ask, one you'll ask, then I will allow Mr. Zaveri, after you all have finished your two questions and one minute. After they have finished their two questions, you have finished your two, I'll allow them to leave. Then the other two who have missed their chance will be given permission. Beyond that, those who are missing because of these two people will be given a chance. Beyond that, I will not allow. Please, we have to complete the program. Yes, sir.
Assalamu alaikum.
Madam, short, brief and to the point.
Dr. Saab.
Sir?
Dr. Saab.
Brief. Kishori, sir?
Yes.
Brief and to the point.
My question is this. I went to see the picture, Khane Khuda. There was a session of 3 days. So people, Haji Saab, they were wearing sandalwood. And then besides that, not eating any as a non-meat food, no haircut, nothing, complete brahmachari or sannyasi.
Second, no?
When the picture was over, I asked them, "Bhai, what is this? Those 3 days complete renunciation, sannyasi or brahmachari." What reply they gave? He said, "Khane khuda tha." Maine kaha, Musliman bhaiyo, sara sansar khane khuda nahi hai.
भाई साहब हमारे चीफ गेस्ट को और हमारे स्पीकर को जाना है, प्लीज पुट फॉरवर्ड योर क्वेश्चन.
सारा संसार खाने खुदा है, प्लीज रिप्लाई टू मी दैट. वो दो 3 days दे वर ऑफरिंग इज खाने खुदा. व्हाट अबाउट द होल वर्ल्ड इज खाने खुदा? व्हाई द किलिंग शुड नॉट बी स्टॉप्ड एवरीवेयर, स्पेशली इन इंडिया? दिस इज मैस.
सर, वी विल नॉट अलाउ दैट क्वेश्चन. Sir, on the request of the chief guest and the speaker, will not allow that answer. May we have the...
Mr. Rashmibhai Zaveri requested the person to ask a question out of turn. I am willing to answer. If chairman says no, then I will. I would love to answer if you allow me. Okay. Anyway, I will control you. Nothing will go wrong.
Okay, we'll allow him, but a short this thing. What was the question? I didn't hear it.
I heard the question. I'm supposed to answer. It's a very good question.
Okay, now quickly and a quick answer, then we'll allow the other gentleman.
It's a very good question.
Yes.
It's a very good question. It will not create problems. I believe though you all are vegetarians out here, we aren't that violent. It won't create problems, I take guarantee. I will not say something that will create violence. Yes, I know there are non-veg and veg meats in Ahmedabad and Gujarat and there were riots and all here. As far as I'm concerned, I speak logical, then nothing happened. The brother asked a very good question. He said that he had seen pilgrims going and for 3 days, they didn't have meat. They didn't have meat. It's on Islam. It's on Islam.
Why Islam allows like this? No, he's asked a question.
He's asking a question on Islam.
No, but that's non-veg.
He's not asking on Jainism. What's the problem? Are you so much afraid that the answer will make him a non-veg? He will yet be a veg. No problem. I don't want you to become a non-veg. The brother asked a very good question, that why there don't you have non-veg? It's a misinformation. I've been for Hajj several times. Whoever told you a lie that we don't have non-veg. The rule out there is that in that sacred part, at that time, you cannot kill any animal for hunting. At that time only. But not eating non-veg. I've gone there. I eat non-veg. Who says you can't eat non-veg? Yes, we are dressed up in 2 pieces of unsewn cloth. You know why? Because it's the biggest annual gathering in the world. People come from America, from Canada, from India, from Pakistan, from Indonesia, all dressed up in 2 pieces of unsewn cloth. Identical. You cannot make out the person next to you, whether he's a king or a pauper. For universal brotherhood.
not theoretical, practical. Universal method. When we offer salah, we offer salah shoulder to shoulder. We eat food, we eat together. We eat even non-veg. Where you got this from, I don't know. Whoever told you, whether Muslim or non-Muslim, he has told you total falsehood. I am telling you, I have been for Hajj several times, I have been for Umrah, it's totally wrong. And for universal brotherhood, everyone comes there. So that you can make out people from various parts of the world, we have to be one brotherhood. Islamic brotherhood is that all human beings are brothers. And Muslims are brothers in faith.
Yes, brother.
Mr. Zaveri, this question is for you. At the end of your speech, Mr. Zaveri, this question is for you, please.
Yes, put forward your question.
Mr. Zaveri is having his attention there. Mr. Zaveri, this question is for you. At the end of your speech, you have listed 16 points differentiating between the herbivorous animals and the carnivorous animals. Now, I don't feel there is anyone in the audience to know these differences, except that you want to give emphasis on the point that giving the comparisons of herbivorous animals, you want to reflect that we humans should also be herbivorous, that is, we should be vegetarian. This is what I understand. Dr. Zakir has already touched few of the points. Now, Dr. Zakir and Mr. Zaveri, I'm not a medical student by profession, I'm an engineering student. I had biology only up to my 10th standard, and thereafter only I had gathered some knowledge from here and there.
Ask your question, please.
Now, here are the points which I want to get a comment from your side is that you have said that pitalin is there in the saliva of the herbivorous animal. It is there in the carnivorous animals and it is there present in the humans also. Now, you have said that herbivorous animals rotate their jaws while eating. I have never seen a man rotating his jaws.
It's a question of your... If you want to put a question, you are most welcome. We are not here to hear your impressions. You are most welcome to ask me a question. Ask me a direct question, I will be too willing to give you a reply.
Because Mr. Trivedi and myself,
we have got other appointments, we will be leaving after this.
You ask your question in three to four sentences, that's all.
What was the need for you to give the differentiation between herbivorous and carnivorous animals? What do you want to emphasize?
Yeah, it is a very natural thing that when I stated that almost all limbs and parts of the body of human being are very similar to herbivorous animals, it is for the enlightened audience to decide whether you agree with me or not. If you agree, it's well and good. Otherwise, if you don't agree, then also well and good. Who am I to say that you must agree on one point or others? That's okay. Because what I have stated is a scientific fact, which I have got reasons and I have got proof for that. But it is for the audience to see whether it is you are agreeable to that or not. So my only point was that by nature, a human being is not only more, but 100% he is herbivorous, and by certain circumstances or by some other reasons, he has been made a carnivorous. Now friends, I must tell you that I am extremely delighted to be here this morning and sharing our views, and so many misconceptions about Islam is now cleared by our learned Dr. Zakir. We never knew that these things are said in Islam, and for that I am extremely thankful to Islam Research Foundation, and I am also thankful to my friend Mr. Salecha Rushabh Foundation, and because of the time constraint of Mr. Trivedi and myself, because we have got other engagements, we will take your leave, and again, thank you very much.
Mr. Bade has to ask. Yes, you are Mr. Bade? Yes. No. Well, excuse me. Mr. Bade has been requested specially to be given a chance to ask question. We have honored that request, and he will be given a chance now. After that, Mr. Trivedi, the last question from that side, and then, yes, last question. From there, ladies, I think are less in number, so we disallow those two questions which were missed out. I hope that would be fair, Mr. Trivedi. Yes, Mr. Bade, then you, and then we finish the session. Yes, Mr.
Hari Om to Hindus.
After we conclude the session, two people will get a chance to hear Dr. Zakir. If you want to hear the answer, and those who want to hear can stay back, others can go. Yes, Mr. Bade.
Hari Om to Hindus, Jai Jinindra to Jains, Salam Walekum to Muslim Bhai.
Walaikum assalam.
A request to Dr. Zakir,
I have all the answers of all your 20 questions, but that will not allow. Kindly give me chance. Any time you will get the logical answers of all the 20 questions, number one. Now, all the religions, they follow the God. God is almighty. Now, that means one should follow his rules also. Now, what is given by the God, the rules formed up by the God? Ek seedhi si baat hai, ki jab Bhagwan ne hame janam diya hai, to unhone hamare liye kuch vyavastha bhi ki.
I would apply the same rule to the last speaker. 1 minute. Put your question in 5 sentences. Assume Dr. Zakir and Mr. Zaveri know the background. Ask your question. 6 sentences, please.
I'm asking you the question only. तो भगवान ने हमारे लिए जो भी कुछ दिया है उन्होंने कुछ रूल फॉर्म करके दिए हैं, जैसे कि हमारे लिए सबसे इसेंशियल बात है हवा की, प्लेंटी ऑफ हवा इज अवेलेबल, अबंडेंट हवा इज अवेलेबल, उसके बाद पानी रहता है, पानी वेयर योर यू को पानी इज अवेलेबल. नाउ अदर थिंग इज फूड, विच आई एम कमिंग टू द क्वेश्चन. द फूड भगवान हैज गिवन अस द फूड ऑल्सो. कश्मीर में है, हमारे लिए कश्मीर में है, इलाके के मुताबिक दिया है. कश्मीर में है हमारे लिए आलमंड्स दिए है, काजू दिए है, बादाम दिए है, पिस्ते दिए है, जहाँ के वहाँ जरूरी है. वन सेकंड, राजस्थान में जाओ आपको वहाँ वो टेम्परेचर के मुताबिक आपको खरबूजा मिलेगा, तरबूजा मिलेगा. यहाँ हमारे लिए वन सेकंड क्वेश्चन आई एम टेलिंग यू, यहाँ हमारे लिए हलवा बना के केले पे ऊपर रख दिया, और व्हाट एवर इजीली इज अवेलेबल ही हैज गिवन इज प्लेंटी. नाउ व्हाट एवर ही हैज गिवन इज प्लेंटी इज चीपर, एंड व्हाट एवर ही सेज नो इट इज नॉट टू बी टेकन और इट इज रिस्ट्रिक्टेड शुड बी he has made it costly. So are we following the rule of the God?
Sir, what very is your question good. On this topic?
Very
he
good.
Understood. Okay.
Very, I understood the question. Very long question. Very good question. See, I'm in the field. I can make out the question. I'm in the field. Regarding the first part, that you can answer all 20 points. I've got various students in this field. I'll ask one of my students to have a dialogue at IRF. If you want, any time, which date? Next Sunday. Next Sunday. Not me, my student. Next Sunday.
I can answer to anybody.
Next Sunday.
Anybody.
Next Sunday.
Anybody.
Okay, no. Done. Next Sunday you are invited. What's your name? What is your name?
Everything will be given.
Mr. Bade will come to IRF at 10:30. Fine. 10:30 morning. Sunday. Same format here, and my student will debate. Anyone. Same topic. His question, that God has provided air, right, water, everything easily available. So why go for things which are uneasily available and costly? Very good question. That you have to point out to Mr. Zaveri. He is telling that vegetables should be transported to Arctic Circle. Vegetables should be transported to deserts. Tell him, I didn't say that. I am saying if vegetable is available, have vegetable. If animal is available, have the lawful animal. You have to pose that question to him, not to me. Point number one. You should have easily available food as long as it is lawful. We should have expensive food, you told me. It's like I telling a rich person, why are you living in Nariman Point? You know, 1 square feet of land, apartment, Nariman Point, costs 25,000 rupees. Come to Mira Road, only 1,000 rupees per square feet. When the rich man can afford to pay money to buy a good flat, why are you preventing a rich man to buy good food? And non-veg food, in protein, and in various ways, medically, it is superior, it's of higher quality. So if rich man can afford it, why are you stopping? If you can't afford, have vegetables. I'm not stopping you. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you for your enthusiasm. We'll not allow that question. Mr. Zaveri said he would like to, he's exhausted, and we respect his views. He would like to leave, so we'll not allow that question, but we'll allow two people here who are to ask questions after Mr. Zaverian leave, because I promised them. Just no. Yes, Mr. Dhanraj Sarlecha would propose a vote of thanks, after which those who would like to leave may leave, those who would like to hear those two questions and two answers may sit.
One question from the lady's side.
It's not working. Hello.
The meeting would be formally closed. Only two questions. Hello. After the meeting would be allowed.
Hello. Excuse me, this is one last question from the ladies. This is for Dr. Zakir.
After this, just two people and one from the ladies, no one else would be. One, two, three, four questions.
Yeah. Hello?
Mr. Tavedi is saying I should be strict. Now the thing is that I am being compassionate. I give chance to two people here. Now everyone is demanding of it. What we'll allow? Vote of thanks right away. Then four questions. Two here. One there. Then close. That's final. Yes, Mr. Dhanraj Salecha, to propose a vote of thanks.
Chief guest, Sri YP Trivedi, learned speakers of dialogue, distinguished guests, brothers and sisters. It's really my pleasant duty to offer vote of thanks on behalf of all the three organizations on whose behalf I thank Sri YP Trivedi to spare his valuable time and grace this occasion as chief guest. I'm really thankful to both the speakers for their most interesting and informative discussion, and above all, I thank you all the participants for participating in the debate. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Now we continue on with the four questions. The chief guest, Mr. Trivedi, Mr. Zaveri, are excused. Those who would like to hear the three or four questions aloud may sit back. We will continue in a minute as the chief guest and the speaker leave. The formal program is closed. We will have an informal four questions allowed for the audiences, for the four questioners who didn't get a chance because of my interfering and giving the other speaker the chance. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. We are starting the sequel question answer session right away. Yes, brother.
My question is, are non-vegetarian food deficient in nutrition?
The brother asked a very good question. That are non-vegetarian food deficient in any nutrient? Yes, they are. It would be wrong on my part to say no. I'm not a fanatic non-vegetarian. It's deficient in carbohydrate, vitamin C, but this is easily available in vegetables. Non-vegetarian are vegetables and fruits. They are rich in vitamin C. We can have fruits. But as a normal comparison, a nutritive value, if you analyze the non-veg food, as I mentioned earlier, it contains first-class proteins, high quality, and complete protein. Contains essential fatty acids, even iron, and one of the good foods is egg, which the speaker spoke so much against egg. The egg contains about 6 grams of protein, one large egg. The half of it is an egg white, and the egg white is known as an ideal protein. Ideal protein means a protein by which other proteins are judged. It contains all the essential amino acids in the right quantity. Egg also contains riboflavin, iron, folate, vitamin B12, vitamin D, vitamin E. One of the few only foods which contain vitamin D is egg. Egg is given to people who are sick and are convalescing, who are improving from sickness. You know why? It's easily digested. Contains all the requirement. Spoke so much about egg. It has little negative factors also. It's also called a nutrient-dense food because it contains all the essential nutrients in the right quantity without excess of any one particular substance and contains less calorie. Contains 70 calories only, one large egg. But there are many foods which contain essentials, amino acids, which are not there in the veg food. In the veg food, what we have to do, if we require all the nutrients, a person can be a veg and get the nutrients how? By selecting the particular diet, by selecting the vegetables eating. If this vegetable is deficient in one amino acid, have the other vegetable which has it. So if he selectively chooses in the correct balance and monitors it, then he'll be healthy. In non-veg food, just have a non-veg food and normally you won't be deficient in the nutrients. Hope that answers the question.
Yes, brother.
My name is Babu Bhai Javeri. Dr. Zakir Naik mentioned in his speech, he tried to quote authorities, alternative to Dr. Dean Arnish. Dr. Dean Arnish has been a pioneer in the field of research on reversal of heart diseases, and he has now come to be acclaimed as an authority. His contribution to the field has been recognized by the President of the United States by appointing him as an advisor to advise Americans on health matters. It is at the instance of Dr. Arnish that now it has been incorporated in the authoritative medical textbooks that heart disease can be reversed through the diet which has been practiced and preached by Dr. Arnish. And this particular diet consists exclusively of vegetarian food. Now, I would like to know from Dr. Zakir Naik, when he has quoted alternative authorities, what he has to say about Dr. Dean Arnish's research, which has cured thousands of patients of coronary disease without bypass surgery.
Brother, that's a very good question, very relevant question, to the point. That what do I have to speak about Dr. Arnish, who's very famous, and he has said that the heart disease can be reversed by food which is only vegetarian food. I agree. Does it make non-veg food prohibited? Do you know diabetes mellitus? Brother, diabetes mellitus, you don't require Dr. Arnish to say if a person is suffering from diabetes, severe diabetes mellitus, if he doesn't take non-veg treatment of insulin produced by bovine, by pancreas of cow or of pig or human being, he will die. So if a non-veg food can cure diabetes mellitus, that doesn't make veg food prohibited. I agree with Dr. Arnish. It proves that heart diseases can be prevented or cured by veg diet. I agree. But what Mr. Rashmi Bhai Zaveri said, Dr. Arnish said, it should be prohibited as a general rule. For heart patient, I agree. People may differ. Many doctors may differ. I agree. But to say because it cures heart disease, non-veg should be prohibited as a general rule, then why isn't America banning non-veg food? Advisor to American government. Advisor to American government. Why doesn't the government take the advice of Dr. Arnish and stop non-veg food? Why? What his research is, if he's authority, he's right. But to quote authority and then say he banned it, I doubt whether Dr. Arnish ever banned it. I doubt. I have my doubts. Show me the statement where he says that no human being ever in this life should have any non-veg food. I challenge you. He may say heart patients. There are other authorities I quoted. Dr. William T. Jarvis. Dr. K. Jerry. Several. But I am more pragmatic. I agree with him. It's helpful in curing heart disease, not as a general rule. Hope that answers the question. I'm very clear.
Yes, sister.
This is regarding, since Dr. Zakir is a scientist and a doctor himself, so I would like him to enlighten me on the 15 years of clinical trial on...
I didn't get the question, sir. Can you repeat the question?
15 years of clinical trial at the National Cancer Research Institute at Maryland in USA on this red meat. Red meat causes cancer and all those things. Is it possible for him to enlighten me on this? Thank you.
It's a very good question. The sister said out of 15 years of research in some cancer hospital. Research, again, not fact. There's a difference between research and fact. But I agree with that research also. I've read that research. Whether from cancer hospital or which hospital which she's referring to, I've read several research that it does cause cancer of the colon. Excessive eating of non-veg causes cancer of colon if it doesn't contain diet rich in fiber. If the diet is rich in fiber, however much meat you have, it will not cause cancer. If it's combined with excessive eating of non-veg and lack of fibrous diet, you know, veg food you eat, it can't be digested because the cellulose can't be digested. It remains as fibers, which helps in the motility. Excessive eating of non-veg with not eating fibrous diet causes cancer of colon. But if you have the proper combination, everyone having red meat doesn't have cancer. Excessive eating, Quran says it is haram. So they are going against the Quran. They are bound to get diseased. That doesn't mean non-veg should be prohibited. It should be said, excessive eating of non-veg should be prohibited. Hope that answers the question. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alameen.
Thank you very much. Jazakallah khairan for being here today and sharing your Sunday morning with us. Inshallah. We'll be in touch with you.